That's as large as the bark scorpion is going to get. So it could be as old as 10 years old, but it is an adult. And we're finding quite a few of them. They're living right on these brick walls, on these block walls, I should say. They run up into those cracks.
They're pretty fast.
See that? See how he ran up into there? That's his home, right there. Just about every home in Arizona has block walls. Scorpion condominiums, that's what we call them. So you can see vines here. There's no scorpions readily available to see. But what vines will do, they're very beautiful, but they offer vegetation for earwigs, crickets, grasshoppers. These are all things that scorpions will eat. So I do have vines at my home, but I do also treat my walls. It's one of the reasons why it's so important to treat your walls. If you're watering at the base of the walls, your walls are not stuccoed, so scorpions can go in these cracks. They're really a harbor for scorpion problems. We really need to get rid of the source of the problem, which is where the water is out in the yard. By just treating the foundation of the home, you're not going to be able to solve the problem because the pest pressure out here is far too great. I've seen many situations where scorpions will be waiting just right underneath this. Now, a lot of people notice that scorpions will end up right underneath a mat or a towel that they leave on their back patio. And that really is because they are blind. And whenever they're out in the open, they're not very comfortable. See this little baby scorpion right here? Very cute little guy. There he is. He's not happy.
There he is.
Sting me
there
if you
is,
can.
Right there.
There's another one. See it? Just in the rocks everywhere. See that? And I would bet that, judging from what I'm seeing here, I would bet that these baby scorpions are everywhere in the rocks, like ants. These scorpions, they'll either live, and I'll bet you there's a whole slew of them underneath this thing, because there's always water here. Yep. But these rocks are so protected. Look at how moist it is under the rocks. It's a perfect place for little baby scorpions to breed under the rocks. They've got the rocks to protect them from the birds. Moisture from here and from the water drippers and the plants that we see around us is a wonderful environment. This is a perfect place for a baby scorpion to grow up and become a big scorpion. So when people lean things up against their house, it creates great harborage for these scorpions. As you can see, they love to hide in things laying on the ground. I'm a little, oh, he's aggressive. That is the biggest desert striped scorpion I've ever seen, bark scorpion I've ever seen in my life. I can barely even speak, it's so big. I was a little afraid it was gonna run up my leg. But, you know, he's scared. He's been eating, see that little gnat? If we weren't here harassing him, that would be a snack. But yeah, that, it might be a she and she may be pregnant. That may be what that's all about. Anyhow, I just wanted to share that with you. See how he moves when I tap the ground? It's not because he sees us, it's because he doesn't like that tapping. It means a bigger something than him is coming. There he is.
Look at that boy.
Oh, man.
I want him for a pet.
Let's see, I want to touch his stinger. What's up, dude? We'll be back next week.